Earth may be dying. Some are looking off-world for a fresh start. The competition for land and resources out here is brutal. In this winner-take-all environment, people are doing anything to succeed. You need to stake your claim, earn your place, and do your best to save humankind's future.
Hello again, everyone. It is Black Knight. Thanks to my good friend Pazesco, I have a new game. Business Building 7. Okay, what are we doing here? Sign up for the Business Building is Hard Work. Sign up for this exciting seminar offered by Yoshimi Robotics to help you help us. Okay. Wow, that music's loud. Can we turn that down? Is that like a... Can we do some options? Audio. Okay, a little less audio. It's not bad music. It's just like graphics. They're up. Time limit. No limit. And let's leave it at 100 just for the heck of it. Not like we're speed boosting here. Okay, let's just get back out. What? It's loud again! What the heck? Did I not save the options? Is that the thing? Okay. There we go. Help me to help you. Trusted helpers, ever working, till the end, Yoshimi Robotics. Despite Joji 5's best efforts, the occasional small pet shipment has diverged from the colonies to wherever Rennie 6 is stationed. Bunnies! There's bunnies? Okay. Hello, human. Hi. Welcome to Mars. I am Joji 5, and we'll be overseeing your upgrade to knowledge. Your upgrade to knowledge! I might steal that one. This planet is quite dangerous. You will learn about the resources to be found here and how they can be used to grow a business. We expect you to upgrade the Yoshimi Robotics facilities and secure an adequate source of power. Your decisions will be less than optimal. This is unavoidable and quite human. I'm the man for the job. I'm the woman for the job. Okay, so I'll be the man for the job because I actually happen to be the man. What a magnificent achievement. This is the finest of Yoshimi Robots facilities. These headquarters will serve as both a warehouse to store our goods and a factory to create new structures. So this is the center of it all. With the leadership position correctly in place, this factory should be able to outproduce any competitor with no untoward risk to life or limb of humans back on Earth. Quite right. Metal resources. This is an ideal location which is with rich aluminum and iron deposits nearby. Iron, aluminum. Okay. Why are there different number of cubes? The number of cubes for each resource represents the density of the deposit. Mining a deposit doesn't use it up, but higher deposit yields more resources over the same time period. So that just becomes a source. To access metals, you need to extract them by building mines where they are found. So we want to build right there and right there. Okay. Click and drag on the terrain. Okay, so this is the camera. Zoom in and out, and whatever else you want to do here as far as do. Okay. Feels very StarCraft. Okay. You click on that claim tile. Just consume one of your claims. Are we not there yet? Construct metal mine. Obviously that one. And obviously that one. Use the ones with the Well, this is pretty. You know, I actually used to work with robots like that. Mining for compliments. Excellent work. Once this mine is complete, you'll automatically begin collecting resources and chipping them back to our headquarters. I have never seen you build this successfully before. You may continue to excel past moderately low expectations. In the past, I have undervalued the need to strongly affirm the simplest of successes. This mistake has clearly been corrected in my latest build. Are you sure you're not missing the point? Okay. Wait for a shipment of aluminum. Okay, so we're getting steel there. Look at that ship go, we're so proud of our fingers. Transport ships automatically deliver resources to our factory from remote locations. Buildings are constructed to our factory. Connected to our factory do not require shipping. Instead, agro production is a good stockpile. Efficiency is desirable, but sometimes you get the right ingredients, patience, and I can be patient. Integers and joy. Patience is quite hard to quantify. We build a mine and it's productive. The number next to the blah blah represents the amount of aluminum we have in storage. Watching those numbers go up bring us joy. That's a lot of aluminum. Rust proof. The aluminum will be used to upgrade our factory. Unfortunately, iron is quite prone to deterioration. Please build a pair of steel mills next. This largely useless iron will be taken and transformed into durable and rust-free stainless steel, which we can use to upgrade our headquarters with more buildings. Upgrading is very important. It's unfortunate how hard it is for humans to upgrade. We are saddened for you, sure. Okay. Let's connect it to the building. Clean tile. Let's see. Is that a good... You have to wait for... What do I have to do here to make it happen? It can't not be connected? Is that the deal? Okay. Claim tile. Claim! What am I doing wrong? I don't know what I did differently. Can we build another one? That connected together, and then we don't need to build two steel mills. Well, if I put that one there, basic optimization routine enabled. Appropriately efficient building placement. Their adjacency to each other boosts their overall productivity. If you build that steel mill next to the other one, they both receive a steel production output bonus of 50%. Woo! This goes okay. I'll keep that in mind. And now we don't need transport. So now we have to upgrade the robotic HQ. Level 1 robotic HQ. Well, how do we do that? By clicking the upgrade button. There's an upgrade button? I don't see an up... Do you see an upgrade button? Is it... Oh, this is the upgrade button. Christian, transform! Without a shadow of a doubt, you are a person who gave the order that successfully upgraded our factory. If it not for your efforts, we have upgraded in half the time, which of course irrelevant. It is of course irrelevant. The upgrade has given us access to additional land claims, which will allow us to construct more buildings. You have to work and hope you are. I hope you feel it is good. I'm doing a great job. Okay. Pay attention to these new cubes, which are not cubes, but are much pointier. Their color variations create optical excitement. These represent silicon reserves, carbon. Mines are suboptimal for getting zones, which require structures called quarries. Mine for metals, quarries for elements. Quarry is a mine, okay? And we obviously want this one. Clean title. We'll pick the big one. And then... we'll pick that one. Booga booga booga. Okay, so that's looking to me just like a month. Okay, that, now it looks a little different. At least they gave it a little bit of visual. Perhaps it was strange for you, gathering silicon carbon without the knowledge of why. We are simply testing your degree of science. There are many safety precautions of vulnerability to be fully autonomous. We are glad to share that experience with you. We are now friends. Carbon and silicon are useful for many things. My favorites combined with aluminum and general electronics are factors that require electronics to be great to be successful. Help us develop a successful future. Construct an electronics factory, and we want to do that and bump it up so that it, there's no transport. And then it'll all go faster. If you zoom back, it's quieter. That's neat. Build two electronics factories. Okay. Clean tile. Let's see. Do I have to click? I have to click the buttony thing, and then, oh, if we put it next to this electronics factory, then that will maximize them, right? They have to touch each other. That's the thing. This is just a tutorial, so I imagine we'll just have to do this all later again with people shooting at us or something. That's gonna be a thing. Possesco, I like this game. This is cool. This could be like my new thing. My new jam. Okay, now we have to upgrade the... Once again, without emotion. Beauty is a concept I am not programmed to comprehend. It must be similar to the experience of observing the robotic XQ go to a new level. I will share with you a truth. Robotic businesses run on energy. Each building, production facility, and transport vessel contains a certain amount of electricity. Consumes a certain amount. How do I get energy? Solar panels, of course. Solar panels harness the power of the sun for a strong supply of energy. The setting of the sun interferes perpetually. The sun is strong but fickle. Yes, that's true, folks. Wind turbines harness the strong wind currents for a more modest but consistent source of energy. It is tasty when dust storms surround us. Providing us with necessary power to continue our work here is really what a friend would do. I'll help. Okay, so now we know what we need to construct a solar panel. That's the first thing. It can be anywhere. Let's see. Let's connect it to the building, just to be on the safe side. Or can we put it up here on, because you'd get more, you'd think, from there. Okay. I imagine they're going to have us build a windmill. I love my name there, so big. It is nighttime. Now is a good opportunity for a bedtime story. Once upon a time, there was a business where people stopped working and rested. That business was bought by a competitor. The employees were fired and replaced by workers who did not require so much rest. The only thing that stops working after nightfall are things that require the sun. But what about solar panels? It should be obvious to you that our solar panels were completed at an inopportune time. I hope you realize that an alternative power source is required. Considering options, I believe a wind turbine is needed. After you inquire, I'd like to volunteer the fact that I am not afraid of the dark. I'm just saddened by the trust people who appear non-functional. So, new building. Building. Interesting! Now it wants you to be along the edge. Let's put up on the high point. You'd think that would be better. We'll connect it to this mine. So So you can't just put a wind turbine out here. That looks different than what I expected. I expected, you know, a regular... Oh, there you go. That's good. Power hungry. A most unfortunate splitting of the Martian surface can be observed. Warm steam energy emerges from these fractures and provides a good opportunity. Geothermal plants capture the heat from these rare thermal vents and convert to energy. This is a delicious idea! Please construct one of these plants so we have an abundance of energy. Sure thing! Come on. Get to clean the tile and... Poop! Prepare for early retirement. We must be almost done. Early retirement. Wow, such success on your first endeavor. Your time of learning the Yoshimura bike has come to a record. I've decided that our time spent here is more than enough to last me for the rest of my process. It's like I'm full and require no more of your time. With these encouraging words, your upgrade is complete. You now know enough to run a successful business into the ground. Enjoy your time on Mars with your inevitable retirement. Quote unquote. I'm not ready to retire yet. Great job, human. Vince, I'm a great human. Alright, we got an achievement unlocked. This is fun and strangely not aggravating like most of my other games. Corporations are people learning to play. Alright. Seneca Development will now show you how to profit from the life support needs of the nearby Martian colony. Business on Mars is booming. The most exciting opportunities are around the newly founded colonies, like corporations. These colonies are made of people, and people have needs. They require water to drink, food to eat, and oxygen to breathe. If handled correctly, these needs become a lucrative revenue stream and the foundation for a strong business. Entrepreneur Paolo Rubini and his prodigy, Maisie Song, we'll show you the Seneca way of developing Martian real estate. You'll learn how to deftly handle the human element with an eye toward the bottom line. Start. Tip. The majority of Seneca's employees purchased their own tickets to the Mars. I didn't get to read that real quick. Hey, partner. Seneca Development is a market leader in the growing off-world industry revolution. Working with us means you'll be making history. I hope you're as excited about this amazing opportunity as I am. You'll need to be willing to take on mind-numbing debt and soul-crushing responsibilities. But I promise it'll be worth it. Hey, that sounds like life. Sign me up. Nice start. You'll be taking over responsibilities at our new Los Angeles branch. Our business is already well-positioned with a supply of steel, aluminum, and silicon. We've got our power needs covered by a wind turbine on the crest of that crater. We're not content to do fine. Seneca Development will teach you how to expand your internal expectations. We're here to pave the way for the next stage of our business venture. What stage is that? Water is awesome! I love water! Since this new venture involves other people's hard work, you need to make sure they survive out there. Water is the key ingredient for sustaining life on Mars. The little round blue thingy represents underground water deposits. Okay, good supply. Sorry, excuse me. Constructing water pumps on these. Okay. Obviously, the bigger one that's connected. Coffee. Build the water pump. Drink the water here. Nice work on the water production. Maisie is teaching you how to set up a well-run business. I'll show you how to turn a profit. You can see how important extraction of resources is. Even more critical to us is the sale of those resources. Let me introduce you to our customers. They have great needs and deep pockets. Customer. Ooh. The colony is our customer. Older sent some of their finest out here to start a new life. They are willing to brave this harsh climate in pursuit of a better future. Their bravery is fueled by one word, hope. Hope is for a new industrial revolution. Hope for jobs that can sustain their families. Hope to transform their colony into a successful port. Trading with the asteroid belt. Their needs will make us money, but their hopes will make us wealthy. How do I know what they want? buying and selling. The resource list is a lot more than a stat sheet tracking your production output. It also shows you the market value of resources, which change dynamically. Ooh, a dynamic market! Based on the supply and demand of the colony. Food is selling at 90 bucks per decabushel. It's a big bushel. You should make a move and invest in some resources into producing food. How do I make food? Factory farming. You're going to need to build some farms. That's a great use for the water we've been collecting. But I have a small problem with that plan. We don't have any glass, and you'll need to construct farms. Sell some surplus resources, buy some glass, and you should be able to construct the farms, okay? Remember, placing your farms next to each other will enhance their output. Okay. So, we need to go up here. What do we don't need? Buy, sell. Okay. You aren't a charity. Okay, so 10, you're practically giving it away. So we want to go... The more you sell, the price goes down. I will show more restraint, alright. Now, where's the glass? The glass? We need 20 glass. Do we need any electronics? Nope. We can now construct a greenhouse farm. And another greenhouse farm. Very nice. I like your style. Putting buildings next to each other is a good way of getting more of a good thing. Each greenhouse farm is now 50% more productive because of their placement. With planning like that, there's no limit to what you can accomplish. And connected to the factory, so therefore no transport delays. And let's see, now we're done then. Sweet, thanks. Perks and bennies! Having a good food supply is not only smart, it's good business. As our expansive HQ grows, so does our staff. You're ensuring our employees have the energy to continue working hard for you in the future. Another benefit we provide to our employees is breathable air. It's a pretty huge perk. Not suffocating is a benefit. O2 and hydrogen fuel. The electrolysis reactor takes water and splits the water in molecules. Oh, that's useful. Hydrogen processing. You are normally, that works. You need more energy than you get out of it from burning the hydrogen. The fuel you start transports oxygen is rapidly cooled and stored in liquid form. Time to mix some O2, baby. Connecting to the plants. Connecting to each other. Anticipate massive profits. This is a beautiful game too. I think it's just so pretty, so smooth and detailed. The Zesco is taking good care of me. Almost there. You have a production pipeline for fuel and oxygen. There's been a hit of supply on the supply snafu though. Air pumping enough water to supply the greenhouse farms and the electrolysis reactor. The number next to the water icon is our production rate. Whenever that number is red, we're using more of that resource than we're making. We're not losing money, but we're losing that piece of generating from the resource. There's also water available in ice fields above us, collected by using solar condensers. This method of water production isn't nearly as efficient as water pumping, but it'll do it a pinch. And further, we're completely out of land claim, so there's that. Claims and opportunities. Maisie tells me we're out of claims. We need more water. That's why upgrading the expensive EQ can, HQ can really help us out. All of the land that you see around is owned by the colony. Claims are given us fairly by the colony for the business that they trade with. By extending our facilities, we earn more of their trust and more claims. Time to upgrade our expensive HQ. Ooh, boogity boogity. Do we want to do the solar condenser or the... Build two solar condensers and a water pump. We're going to put the water pump there. Next to another electrolysis reactor. And then we need to build a solar condenser. As close as we can. Must have 5 glass to construct. Okay, so here's what we have to do. We have to sell. Cash out some food. Where's the glass? Buy some glass. I put it as close. We need some fire. We don't have fire? We're making that, so we're okay. I know the basis of most business is debt, but let's be realistic. The colony isn't going to lend you money to give away their fuel. Before you get any more fuel, the price needs to drop, but we need more cash. Kyle, come on. And obviously, now we need more glass. We need more money. More glass. And then... as close as we can. And we still have a profit! Okay. Good news if you like bad news. I feel keeping bad secrets from you at this point. It's time. I feel bad keeping secrets from you at this point. It's time to come clean. We've started running quite a deficit due to the cost of power since you started. We owe over $32,050. That one wind turbine isn't quite enough to supply all our structures with the required power, and the colony has been selling us energy at the market rate. I hope what? Listen, don't forget about the debt. Listen, running business is really stressful. Don't worry about all that money we owe. Seriously. You can pay off your debt whenever you have extra cash, but it's better to reinvest it for a better infrastructure. Too much debt can literally crater your opportunities in the future, but let's focus on making more money instead. We know we can safely handle our current debt because of its current bond rating. Bond rating? Any company that has debt is assigned a bond rating, ranging from AAA, which is excellent rating, to low interest rates, to D, a poor rating, which has high interest rates and indicates a company may collapse from debt. These ratings go down as the company gains debts and improves as they pay debt back. Our bond rating is currently AA, so we're still in a comfortable spot, but we also have some room for improvement. Build some power producers so we can move from an energy deficit to an energy surplus. Okay. We can do that. Let's see, we'll put this out here. Okay, can we claim it? Okay, so they're being built. Like that, he built the first solar panel! Okay. Is that our stock price? Your stock. If your rival players control more than 50% of a player's company stock, the company becomes a subsidiary and the player is eliminated. 6,000 shares owned by Black Knight, 4,000 shares unknown. That's interesting. Energy independence. Check out these wonderful numbers next to the energy icon. We're running a surplus and making money by selling the extra back to the colony. Of course, the money we're making by auto-selling our energy so this gets added to our debt. Hopefully the money we're making by auto-selling our energy surplus gets applied to our debt. Okay, you can see it goes down. Hopefully you can see why I wasn't too worried about our debt. Using our cash to make more money is the best way to stay out of debt to begin with. What's next? There are a lot of things you can do to increase our profits, but fortunately we're out of land claims again. You know the drill, upgrade, and then we'll talk. Boy. Buy glass, upgrade the... The colony just gave us a bunch of new land claims. I think it's pretty clear what our next move is. The price of glass is looking really good. We helped drive up the price up by buying so much. Let's flip the script and recoup some of that cash by producing some glass of our own. Invest in glass. Glass kilns are enormous kilns where oxygen is burned to melt silicon into large glass panels. Glass is made from the following. Oxygen and silicon. These sturdy panels are used throughout the colony to enable us to make Mars a beautiful place to do business. Believe me, without the fantastic views and the expansive HQ, we'd have a hard time with our executive retention. I'd like an office with a view. So to a new building. Again, we want to attach it, if at all possible. Clean town. Where is it? Glass kiln. Boof. Can I do but two of them? I have to do three of them. Our timing couldn't be much better. A minor industrial accident blew out almost every window in the colony's research module. I love to see prices go up. Shortages like this occur from time to time. Sometimes the result of problems with the colony, other times the expected shipments from Earth don't arrive on time. Doesn't matter. Plus, we can profit from the shortages. Isn't this price gouging? Listen here, if you need glass, you may feel like price gouging. It may feel like price gouging, but in reality, isn't that demand has gone up and supply hasn't kept pace. We're in a free market, friend. This is what laissez-faire looks like. Demand goes up, feel free to worry about the details, but only after you figure out how to profit from the opportunity. Time to make your money. Spectacular use of real estate. Not only are your real estate claims on point, but you've also constructed the most efficient layout for three buildings of the same type. Each glass kiln is producing glass at a 75% quicker than individual structures. I'll get you promoted. I'm looking forward to a raise already. Yeah, glass. Okay. Build an elemental core. We can do that. That's the wrong thing, isn't it? Nope, that's an elemental quarry. Where's our next elemental quarry? No, I didn't want that. That was an accident. Can I cancel? Top-notch performance. It can be easy to lose your head when the market heats up. Keeping your cool and focusing on results shows what you have what it takes to compete. Our business is rolling along with that glass sale. You have a solid cash influx that gives you options moving forward. A side benefit is a strong business is the colony benefits as well. An actual win-win. As you can see, the colony has grown since we started working together. This is due in large part to our hard work. Earth is hoping that the colonies can revive humankind's future, but it's businesses like ours that will ensure their success. We don't influence how the colony grows, but the expansion affects how colonies can greatly affect the prices of resources. Okay, that makes sense. This is the shipping and receiving heart of the colony, the port. Every resource brought or sold finds its way into this port. Rolling over the port will provide you with an overview of the colony's consumption. As a business, we care a lot about construction materials. The colony is populated by citizens and their life support needs make up the majority of their consumption. And where are the buildings around the port? The most important structures are the habitat units that grow the population of the colony to grow. The more a colony grows, the more they consume. An expanding colony is good for business. The colony has a large number of specialty structures it will utilize when it expands. Foundries, laboratories, machine shops, offices, and warehouses, name a few. You can always roll over the structure to more. How will this help our bottom line? It's the people! Just like corporations, colonies are people. After a busy day at work, some people need to take a break, blow some steam. Who knows what people need more than a well-run business? No one, that's who. Maisie Song is going to tell you about the amazing revenue stream that results from a well-placed pleasure dome. What? Relax. The pleasure dome is a place where workers can take a break from long hours of toil. They pay handsomely for a release from their daily grind. As more people arrive in their new habitats or upgraded company headquarters can become quite lucrative. As more people arrive in new habitats or upgrade company headquarters, it can become quite a lucrative revenue stream. We should build one next to the colony, preferably adjacent to as many habitats units as possible. Real estate's always... Okay, so. What am I building? That's it here? Okay, we have to buy 40 electronics. Construct a pleasure dome. Okay, those are the habitats, so that connects to... I think right there. The pleasure dome. Can we build two pleasure domes? Perfect! You really know how to make the best of a good idea. By strategically placing the pleasure dome between all those habitats, you've ensured optimal profit. Strong decision making is the way to help rise to the top. It's really been a pleasure to walk you through the cynical way. Thank you. You rock! The pleasure dome is going to provide a nice income for us. That's what business is all about. Finding out what people need and selling it at an inflated rate. You're now certified to plan and execute a successful business by sake of the law. Before leaving, please sign this non-disclosure and non-compete agreement. What happens if you refuse to sign? Fun times with Ted! Climb the corporate... I guess it doesn't matter. But I refuse to sign, so Learn from Reclamation Industries what it takes to win a market competition against an economic rival. Okay. What's Iowa University? That's a different thing. Okay, make it work. Reclamation Industries provides opportunities for hard workers beset by unfortunate circumstances. By committing to a 5-year contract, debts are forgiven and records are expunged. Especially if you're a criminal. Sam Moreno will show you how to identify an ideal founding location for setting up a successful scavenger outpost and a good way to start off strong. The colony of New Amsterdam has just opened its borders to outside investors. It's quite possible that you will face some competition. Okay, now we start to beat people up. Wow. Reclamation Industries, transform today and hope for tomorrow. I guess I'll have to pause it to see that. About Reclamation Industries, for you can help found the scavenger headquarters. First off, we don't use stainless steel as a building material. It's good for stuff that's over-engineered, but our lower safety standards allow us to use carbon compounds as a primary building. Carbon is found in and around impact craters. We can extract it rapidly and convert to a wide range of construction supplies. People question using construction materials that haven't been field tested yet. People should really mind their own business. We also use aluminum and glass. Okay. Why is most of the map dark? Someone's first rodeo! Time to learn how to identify a good spot to set up shop. The most important choice you're going to make is one of the first ones required. Where to set up the scavenger HQ. We know the locations of mineral deposits surrounding the nearby colony, but we need to perform deep scans to verify the types of these minerals. Scans? Yep. Basic scout and recon. Click an area to perform a magnetic resonance scan. This is where we know resources are, but we won't know much more than that. We're expecting you to spot a few good locations before you decide where we found. To have a foundry or what we found. Okay, I won't let you down. Water low. Water low. Silicon high. Aluminum low. Water low. Can we get them all in one scan? Nice and balanced. This is a nice spot to found this. A nice spot to found the scavenger HQ. It provides the construction supplies critical for upgrades. Plenty of water support the life support needs of our crew. I like this kind of place. So somewhere here. That's got water, aluminum, iron. Diverse resources. Here's an interesting spot. It's tricky because the construction resources aren't strong, and the closest water is great, but silicon is always useful for both glass and electronic production. And having a geothermal source by makes this location very tempting. Keep in mind that our start here would be slow off the get-go. We're still scanning. Fast upgrades, great construction supplies. That's a hell of a lot of carbon and aluminum. This will give us a fast start and allow a quick upgrade with plenty of core construction materials. I wish there was a better supply of water. Life support matters. Some of us even brought our families on this venture. Starting fast is good. Our luck seems running high at the moment, and you're making me no longer regret letting you tag along. Since it seems you're so charming, why don't you make the call? When we found any resources under the scavenger, you get strip mined. It's a good burst of resources, but we can't access them as a supply later. You can always spend time carefully weighting the strengths. Be hard call. All right. Found the scavenger HQ. So it's either here or it's balanced. Here with the diverse resources, it'll be slow. I think we should go balanced. We're taking a huge chance of moving out here. Some of us don't have much to lose in the first place. Wasn't satisfied working hard for another profit. Frank couldn't afford his home payment. Now he's got a 5-year plan. Different background, same goals. Some of our crew are even recently paroled. Oh, yeah. Is Frank a criminal? Watch it. Just because some of us have debts to repay doesn't mean you're going to look down on me. No one lives a life without a few regrets. I'm willing to come to a full account for my shortcomings. Be careful with the conclusions you're willing to jump to. Enough of the lecture. A ship just landed and there's work to be done. Start gathering some construction materials and get water flowing to our headquarters. Yeah. Okay, so we should be able to do this. Construct a water pump. Adjacent. That's the only one we got. Okay, can we build another one? Need approval to build more. Okay. Construct a metal mine. There's more there, but yeah, let's go here. Let's go close. Elemental quarry. Next to each other to maximize. Just waiting for it to build then. Okay. I love reclamation industries. While others mine iron and have to refine for steel, we build straight from carbon. Reminds me of a contract Henry Ford made with the machine shop. There were strict guidelines on how to package and ship the engines they built, down to the type of wood used. After the engine was delivered, the crates were pulled apart and used as floorboards. Every angle was key. It's a little something for nothing. Take care of your workers. Because of our reputation, it isn't just for business centers, the primary residence for our workers. Clean air. Okay, so we need some glass. We're doing. There we go. Greenhouse farm. Water pump, we're going to bump it next to this water pump. Again, we're not keeping this, so it's not hypercritical. I wonder what the difference is, whether you have a scavenger HQ or a corporate HQ. Is that like a choice? Not bad. A fine start for you. We've got reliable production where most of us, and we won't be needing any food or water from the county. We're in this together. Okay. Hello, neighbor. I am excited to be nearby to your location for this business venture. So many things are happening each day. Competition brings out the best of us. Expecting a package soon. Please let me know by accident if it's received by you. Will do, and good luck. There goes the neighborhood. Seems like we've got some competition for New Amsterdam's business. Fresh from Yoshimi, the latest in human replacement technology. Trusted helper is ever working till the end. We're only helping the rich take even more, Dan Robust. He seemed nice to me. Land grab. Should have snagged that vent while we had the chance. Now our competition has a shiny energy source and we're left high and dry. And it won't stop there. This whole endeavor is one big competition. We're fighting over the land resources and most importantly, the colony's business. It's the first move. To win this competition, we'll need to outsmart, outproduce, and outsell them. A good indicator of our value is our stock price. It will always appear next to your name. Let's begin by producing some wind turbines so our energy costs don't become their profits. Energy price is looking good. This is a chance to make some extra cash for our surplus energy production. We could invest in more energy producers, but when the energy crisis is over, we'd be left with some useless land claims. If those bots hadn't snatched that geothermal storage, we'd be the only supplier in town. Too late now. Friends in low places. This is one of those times of being undesirable is desirable. Our business is on the straight and narrow, but there are plenty of folks scraping by, involved in activities that are less than legit. So, many of our workers have suffered under the thumb of big business. May the independents prefer working with us.
Allow me to introduce myself.
You know, I went to a Russian accent without looking at his name. That's hilarious.
Allow me to introduce myself. Call me Raskolnikov.
Raskolnikov.
I represent a group of independent contractors operating wherever works are to be had on this frozen wasteland. We're called the Black Market Regulars by locals. If you're serious about surviving out here, you'll refer to us as friend. Now, we provide exceptional services at a competitive price. Would you find it hard to compete with business as usual, we can provide more interesting options. Independence. A business of criminals. We deplore organized crime of any type, which is why we are so proactive in damaging the interests of these so-called honest endeavors. There is nothing so organized or so criminalized nature than what is commonly referred to as a corporation. We will sell you the services and tools you need to quickly remove that smug smile from their self-satisfied elites that you are loggerheads with. Nice to meet you. Raskolnikov's a good man to have friendship. We're going to hire some of his associates to enact a mutiny on that geothermal plant that the robot seems so proud of. There's money to be had in that energy market. We don't see the need to share it. You want me to steal it? Survival isn't always pretty. Our lives and futures are on the line here. Most of us have families looking to come off world with us. Fighting over scraps here is an improvement over their lives on Earth. If it's a choice between me and mine and some job-stealing corporate algorithms, you best believe it's not even a choice. It makes it easier. Think of it like borrowing sugar from an egg. They'll get back soon enough. Time to go borrow that geothermal. Purchase a mutiny. Where do you purchase a mutiny? Where's the mutiny button? Where's the mutiny button? Oh, down here. And do it. That geothermal plant is redirecting its power to our way for a while. Time to enjoy the fruits of someone else's labor for a change. Let's expand the scavenger HQ land claims. Those claims, I suggest we push into glass production. New glass, because for upgrading, Kelly, we need glass. Electronics, ba-doop-ba-doop-ba-doop. I trust you. Okay, so we've got the geothermal plant somewhat temporarily, sadly temporarily. Okay, we don't need this iron. We don't need the aluminium. We need... Oh, do we have to upgrade it? Okay. Build a wind turbine. Bump it up for the bonus. Build an elemental quarry on silicon. That's a pretty good one. And then build two glass kilns. There is, we want to
together. Who is neighbor? Do you retain a memory of this geothermal plant? Recalling its story brings up complex connections with it. We do not understand the relationship to energy. We have carefully constructed an example. This is called a teachable time segment. Sorry about that. Better neighbor now. Human consumption is food. Observe green factories of water consumption. EMP discharge will make these inoperable. Hunger and emptiness. Leave neighbor alone now. Please learn. That's a tough way to treat a neighbor. Can't believe the nerve of them. Our people need to know that food stays productive. Need our food to stay productive. They know that. If they want to play hardball, we will certainly accommodate them. Let's buy some electronics to build a hacker array. This will be a more useful addition to our business. The hacker intercepts interspace communications and adds a little something extra. Instead of food supplies are en route to delivery, no imminent delay is present. Their message received by the colony becomes no food supplies, imminent delay is present. Fact on price is almost immediate and would throw this with a huge edge. Oh, that sounds totally legal. Okay, we have to upgrade the XQ again. Should we build? It must be connected to the HQ. Oh, look, there's a running tale of what's going on here. Okay, it's under construction. This is going to take a little while. Can we... It won't let you just build anything else. We have to wait here. We have to follow the path. But I'm looking forward in the future to really just going crazy with this. This looks like it could be my new jam.
The hacker array is finished. Time to change our passwords.
Okay,
protection! Always a good investment. Glad to see the mutiny was for your satisfaction.
Seems like you're getting good advice from Sam as well. Anytime you build something worth having, it pays to invest in some protection. My goon squad will ensure the safety and security of any location you're concerned about. Protection is not their only function. If a competitor is foolish enough to target a protected site, my team will capture and reverse engineer as a response for use at your leisure.
Sounds like a good insurance policy.
Oh, this is the... There we are. Oh my, it looks like they're trying to take advantage of the attack they launched on our farm. Not as innocent as helpful as advertised, but what is? Seems they haven't decided to begin construction on electronics yet. Now let's get electronics production online and use the hack array to short the supply, which will drive prices sky high. Is it working? Do I have to do anything? Okay, how do I do... Is this a button? What do I need to do here? I feel like I'm at a loss. Use the hack array to short electronics. Aha! That's the button! Pays off for patience. Give the hackers some time to get their job done. Spread some information on the wire. Get those electronics factories constructed and make sure that our life support needs are taken care of. Okay, so we need to... Oh, that's a different thing. We need, Let's see, where are those? Yeah, that's where we want it.
Dangerous explosives available to the highest bidder.
I'm still sorry about that malicious attack on our farms. This dynamite can be used to teach those heartless machines a lesson about cause and effect. Don't worry about how much cash we have in hand. Auctions are always paid by taking a loan. You'll increase our debt. Click on that bid button to raise the stakes and those robots know we need business. called the phone today. It's not worth that much. They must be pretty desperate for Renner to pay for their notes for that. I'm not saying, but we dropped it on...
Sold!
I'm not saying we dropped it on them at that price, but I think we ended up with a better bargain. That plus our little insurance policy on the hacker, it always makes me smile. This is like a child bidding with their father's money. Are you allowed to spend that much on money? Who is responsible for a
price manipulations to begin shortly?
Okay, we need to build another electrolysis factory. Now we need two electronics factories. Let's dump them in here and stack them up. And because they're connected, then we don't have any transfer time. Hello again! Our attention is once again diverted to behavior, which is the unbecoming of a neighbor. Well, our attention is once again diverted to behavior, which is unbecoming of a neighbor. You have built the array of lies. A demonstration is prepared to hasten your retirement. Instead of deception, let me share the content of description.
You probably called a dirty rat trying to break our stuff?
As far as they might, they just can't keep up with us. Almost makes me feel bad for what we're about to do. Looks like we're going to have some free dynamite and a nice little target. Time to have a little fun. Those poor robots. Okay, use the dynamite on your opponent. Let's take out their geothermal. So much sadness! There's the concept, kindness. I wish this word was expressed better by you, our neighbor. This loss of our geothermal plant leaves me no happiness. It is with certainty that you are now labeled rival. We are only delayed. A repair is shortly forthcoming. Our relationship would be on repair. Mm-hmm. Goodbye. You tried that on me first. Good on ya. There you go. Gotta love the powerful statements some high-powered explosives can make. Making friends is a fine thing, but this is business. You don't have a choice but to make some enemies. I hope you enjoyed trashing some automated butt. At Reclamation Industries, a fresh start is available for all. I mean, a fresh start, too. Expunge your record! Yay! Alright, we're getting there. Better living through chemistry. Economic disaster and a string of global crises brought to the fears of a modern dark age. Scientific community gathered the emerging shadows to pledge themselves to preserve and expand humanity's knowledge regardless of cost. They call it a foundation. I'm calling Asimovian ripoff. Lana Kalmat and Silas Crichton united their international science teams to form New Meridians. Their sights set on expanding planetary exploration. By competing with other off-world trading companies, they hope to secure funding for even more ambitious projects. Join them to learn how to set up a fully optimized Martian business by balancing the pursuit of science, desire for strong earning statements. I'm sure everything... Okay, I'm digging this already. On giant shoulders, thank you for joining our team. The work here is the first phase of a greater mission. Dark days are ahead. Advanced designs? Think of all the structures used by our competition are based on my initial designs. We shared our research with everyone in the beginning. Our open source policy helped the colonization of Mars secure at a rapid rate. Unfortunately, other companies are using our innovations have no desire to reciprocate. We continue to make significant upgrades. I'll explain the hardware later. Now is the time to identify a good founding location. You know, with steel, aluminum, and glass and require a healthy supply of water. Because of our unique technological advances. So this is another thing you could take. So these guys won't be able to take out other people. They won't have the bad guy element. Each compare is based on the same information. So please avoid the temptation to found immediately. So we have to go through and do the same scanning thing, I guess. Okay, so that looks like they've scanned everything. Do we have any? There's some water over here. High water seems like a thing. But this is a lot of water. A good amount of aluminum. A good amount of iron. Silicon low. This is good over here, too. A lot of aluminum, a lot of water, a lot of silicon. I think it's over here. Okay, we've looked over the entire map. Oh, here's more. More water. This looks even more promising. Look at this. You got the silicon right here, the water, aluminum, iron, water, silicon, carbon. That's the spot. Right here. To cross the line from judicious adjacent to iron. Not a lot of iron. We want a lot of iron? That's a lot of iron, but not a lot of other stuff. Well, actually, this is other stuff. It's all low iron. All right, let's do this. Quite right. What a wondrous sight to behold. Our new home. The top of the line science facility. The business center rolling along. All right. We have a different approach from it. Place in steel mill technology. Instead of building a mine on the iron first, place a steel mill. So it's just all, yeah. Howdy! Looks like we're going to be friendly competitors. No, you're not. I'm not much of a talker, but I always thought a kind word to different groups required. You too. Villainous swindlers, you can't choose your competition, but tens of lists, I wish you could. Not only are they use dangerous materials for their buildings, but their connections allow them to use to exploit the loose business regulations on Mars. They are happy to interfere in matters that are best left alone, using means that are less than admirable. They're just trying to survive. Okay. We're going to build the next one. Adjacent. Build a metal mine on aluminium. And we can't build anything. Normally I would roll right into trying to get water and stuff, but we're doing a tutorial. So I guess when you do this properly, you get to pick whatever style you want. Do you want the corporate style, the science style, or the thug style? That's going to be tough to choose. Rapid and efficient steel is not our only improvement. Once we discovered the advantage of this approach offered, Dr. Crichton was not to be stopped. His goal is to ensure we can minimize the collection of core resources and leapfrog others into harder manufacturing resources immediately. Our improvements are so revolutionary, it's hard to see how any other approach could do. Yeah, okay, I like the sound of that. Hard work is to be admired. It is the work of countless generations before us. Blah, 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 blah. A new paradigm is necessary. Take a look at the redesigned electrolysis reactor. Construct it at a site where water would normally be extracted. Bypassing to pump water with a dedicated structure will get operations quickly and smoothly. Okay. So this is just more efficient. You can bypass, you can just create that here and then create that there. And you get everything. How long before they screw with us and we get to see black market? Purchase a mule? Cook the books? Purchase filthy pirates! Okay. Magnetic storm? Adrenaline boost? Underground nuke? Some of us find the confidence is where it's unsettling. A necessary evil. All of us know it's... Oh no, what are we doing? expand the scope of human knowledge, but we're going to have to make money. Power, fuel, and food. We need to get some of these mission-critical resources online. Okay, so. Construct another glass kiln. Where? Oh, we have to upgrade first. Predict another electrolysis reactor. We want to stack that. Yeah, we need power. Build? Okay, so I think, did we build everything? It's just all building now, right? Yeah, I think we just gotta wait for it to click it all together. What are these things? Oh, Pleasure Doom and the Hacker Array. So we can still do those things, I guess. Good enough is neither. Most companies will be patting themselves on the back and congratulating themselves for a good use of resources. I am not interested in good. I require exceptional. For that to occur, we must continue to expand the scientific XQ, and we must invest significant effort in return. What are we working towards? Should we be content with making a strong profit? I require the possibility of a breakthrough in scientific understanding. Is life unique to Earth, or is it to be found elsewhere? Is humanity's existence an anomaly or accumulation of all events? Our success here provides us the opportunities to... Okay, fine. What are we talking about? Chemical reactions. Dr. Crichton is a true visionary. It's his first name, Michael. Without his drive, we would never have gotten so far so quickly. To aid in this research, he should build chemical refineries that convert the following. A large supply of chemicals allows to rapidly iterate on his early experiments. Chemicals do all that? Being made for an environment that requires protection, we are ability to... Oh, these are rules. Time to build stuff up, okay. Oh, we have to upgrade again. Do we... Oop, okay. Again, stack them. Okay, so where to... Oh, here we go. That's a fairly big distance. Where's the founder? Did we do that? That's that, isn't it? So we need another one? Is that the deal? Or are we just... Are we moving? Okay, let's clear that. Nice operation! Now that we have our infrastructure in place, we can start to take advantage of our chemical production. Fools sell their chemical surpluses for a quick profit, but there's so much more we can do. We're going to build an optimization center. This facility allows for significant improvements in resource collection and manufacturing. You want to build it so it's connected to the scientific HQ either directly or through other structures. So it's got to be connected in, alright. We need water, too! A small water storage that we need to help with by using advanced buildings available. Size steps to need to collect water. Hire service of a mule. Mules is like a terrible idea. We weren't the first scientist to hire your needed resources. A generation before us, Dr. Bunton, pioneered the use of mules. These unique mechanical contraptions provide supplies in the first settlements. All the field units have long since been decommissioned, but there are some that are still functional available through the black market. Old retrofitted tech, what could go wrong? Let's take this one, it's not adjacent. How cute! It certainly is less advanced than our mining structures, but it's fully untethered to the limitations of land claims. Running free over the foreign landscape, it makes you wonder what it'd be like to be on the crystal gear. It's a foreign untouched world. Perhaps I could adopt this mule after the mission is complete. That actually looks like the robots that they've... Yeah, what's that company that actually built it? See, we have to build an optimization center now. How do we do... do we need another one? Okay, there's two. Okay, so that's a little button.
Pirates. I hate those filthy bandits.
This is the type of low-class behavior that accompanies reclamation industries wherever they go. I like to think better of our competition, but they have already proven themselves to be unworthy of it. These despicable pirates interrupt shipments and share their spoils with their investors. Our chemical supply appears to be on their target. Perhaps they're just jealous. Whoops, sorry about those chemicals. The pirates, to be really honest, our involvement in the whole deal. We've had a hard time securing good resources of carbon at this locale. Carbon is critical to our growth, and seeing you aggressively clean carbon tiles for esoteric purposes really raises my hackles. I decided to...
Optimization center is ready. Time to start improving everything.
This is not an adjustment, this is theft. Pirates will leave eventually, but at the moment they're significantly slowing down the supply rate of our chemicals. What do we need the chemicals for exactly? Optimization through chemicals! Optimization Center allows us to dramatically increase the output of our buildings. These breakthroughs require increasingly larger amounts of chemicals. Once a structure improvement is discovered, the upgrade routine is automatically deployed, which allows rapid improvement to our infrastructure. I suggest we try to outpace their thievery with an increased rate of chemical refinement. Okay. Okay. Okay, so here we have this. Chemical production. So that boosts it. Technological advances, like most worthwhile pursuits, take time. While we wait for the appropriate breakthroughs, why not focus on other areas we can improve? We could benefit from having food production. The time has come to build some advanced farms. I think you'll like our farming techniques. Our farming equipment is able to automatically extract moisture from any water sources placed on. Quite an accomplishment. Dr. Crichton recently discovered how to automatically extract the water from our structures placed on ice. To be honest, you would have thought that would be the easiest and most obvious breakthrough. Let's get started.
The engineers have advanced our production.
So, where am I? Here we are. Should be built on an input. Okay, so these they want on a... I thought we were building on ice. Oh, I stole it from the mule. Alright, they'll be built eventually, and then we'll just... We're not building this for the long term anyway. I am having fun, though. I'm getting lost.
Pirates. I hate those filthy bandits.
Clearly, their efforts to thwart our progress will continue. There are a few ways to handle oneself when hostility like this is expressed. Your first option is to take your frustration down on the enemy. Repay each attack with an escalated response. Your second, allow the hot embers to F8 to cool, then use the resolve to your intellect to devolve a counter strategy. But good fight. If we allow ourselves to simply lash out at our opponent, I fear we'd be allowed old Earth ways to shape our future. There is a way to progress further, which will move us beyond the reach of attacks like these. Hopefully, we can outlast the temporary frustration of these infractions. Dr. Crichton has another invention to share with you. Can't we just buy some explosives? Disruptive. Our transportation network makes us very susceptible to attacks, and that vulnerability has been exploited by those good-for-nothing criminals. I've never been satisfied with half-measures and compromises. Instead of playing a game of cat and mouse with these scoundrels, we should opt out of the game completely. The first step is to construct a patent lab. How will that help? The patent lab provides us with the ability to discover the technology of tomorrow today. After construction is complete, we can start researching teleportation. Okay. So, teleport stuff. What are we doing now? Found as okay. Build a patent lab. Which is where? Need $4,000. Okay, well, we just have to go up here. And what we got lots of? Cash it up. Oh, we have to upgrade this? No. Alright, let's bump it up over here. Dr. Crichton told me about your ambitious strategy. Teleportation will be a real game changer. Yeah, unless you've played Doom. We're on Mars experimenting with teleportation? That can't end well. That kind of research will require more chemicals, so more refineries. Gotcha. Whoa! What the hell happened there? Unpredictable weather storms. There's always a storm around here. It's not a solar flare, it's a dust storm, eh? Seems that electromagnetic storm really hit your shipments pretty hard. No worries, though. Our operations were spared. We're making sure any supplies you need are available for the fair price.
The patent lab is constructed. Let's get our science on.
All this research we've constructed is resulting in some pretty high power consumption. We need more power. So we need... Fine, okay. Construct a water pump. Construct a wind turbine. It's interesting how they light up. I think you get more power out of it. Build a water pump. Optimize chemical production. Build a power generator. Now what do we have to do? Okay, so that's for the patent lab. Teleportation! Okay, so you have to select it to tell it to do that. Alright. So we've upped our chemicals. We have to wait a little bit just to see what's going to happen next. Let's sell some chemicals. Our debt's going up. But then again, if we could just... If this was the long
term...
Our
methods continue to improve.
This is a real game changer. We're totally protected from the nefarious actions of criminals and mercenaries, and we'll be able to continue to increase our productivity. I do not disappoint. Also provides with an exclusive patent. You should consider spending more of our chemical supplies. Research thinking machines. Use improved AI developed from our operating systems. Wherever our equipment suffers an attack, the improved routine repairs. Okay, great plan. Moving to electronics production by building fuel electronics factories. You've probably gotten used to the expecting unexpected. You should know that they should be placed in either carbon or silicon. Fine. Let's, pay the debt. We are debt-free and making money. Okay. Upgrade your scientific to level 5 and then boink. So do we need to? It's already constructed. What option is the powerful option to resupply our building? Auto supply. You can activate auto supply in any building type. It ensures that you don't have to. If you don't have the requisite supplies, it will be bought. Okay. Where is the button? Okay. Which means we're gonna bleed money. It's interesting you can turn stuff on and off. Those are producing. Okay, and then we'll put that right on the carbon here. Build two factories. Patent thinking machines, and that means we have to go up here. A lot of neat things. Cold fusion. I like this. Optimize electronic production. How do you optimize? Optimization center. Aha! How do you optimize with the optimization center? Obviously. How long have I been playing this? It feels like 10 minutes. Wow. I am good. We're going to have to finish this tutorial pretty darn pronto because I have other things to do today than really... And I don't think there's anything else for us to do here, just in 8 seconds.
Optimization routine successful.
Well, Excelsior! Very well done. You've become quite adept in the sciences and applied your training proficiently. I hope that you can see how important our work on Mars is. Blah, 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 the number of the banks. Continue your research. Okay, honestly, this has been a long, long trip here. We're going to have to come back. We'll tackle these in a little bit, because I really do. I have life to... how long would it be? I can't give it up! The Power Within. Paolo Rubini will teach you the secrets of unlocking the power within through positive thinking and visualization techniques he spent some lifetime mastering. His experiences in business and colleague development will equip you to make the most out of every opportunity. You will learn that with enough effort, you'll be able to succeed in nearly anything. At the end of your training, you too will be equipped to... Okay, fine. Failure is only minor... Okay. What we have here is a beautiful start to our new Harlem business. We have a good supply of resources that our customer needs, and we're on track for record profits. The problem is that we have competition for their attention, which means that I have competition for their money. Good. How do you do that? Greed is good. And that means... Some of our most expensive resources are food and electronics. We should quickly build more farms and factories. Okay. And you will use the remainder of... As this will use the remainder of our claims, we should also go ahead and upgrade. Nice influx of capital immediately. Okay. That's not bad. Stack them up. Now, where's another factory? Do we have another factory? Well, at least we'll put it here. So that it's connected, we don't have any transport issues. Poopity. Now that one is building adjacent for a bonus. And adjacent for the bonus. Then we gotta wait. Now you're competing with everybody. That's an interesting thing. Nice hustle. Take a look at the names in the upper right-hand corner. You'll see everyone's fighting for New Harlem's business. Each company has 10,000 shares available for purchase. The dollar figure is the per share value. I'll not see my name up there. Shares of a company can be purchased in 1,000 share blocks. Each of those blocks is represented by 10 blocks underneath the share value. But you own 4,000 shares of our company. Most companies own a few blocks of their own stocks. You can buy 1,000 blocks here. Not your own company, but any other company! Use money to make money. Initially, it doesn't make sense to drop liquid access into stocks, but you have to realize that stock ownership is the equivalent of control. Take a note of the way your stock blocks are divided in the middle. If your opponents ever get to buy an open stock that exceeds that mark, you lose control of the company and become a subsidiary. Once you acquire 50% of your company, the majority ownership is given special status. You control the company. Your control of the company cannot be removed by buying one additional block, but it must be done in one fell swoop, a hostile takeover. Buying stock from the company's founder also accrues a double payment, so any additional stock you purchase becomes a firewall, protecting against any targets. Time to buy some stock! Okay, so sell what we got a lot of. Okay, we still have to do a little bit more. Buy one of your stock. Buy. Congratulations on being the majority shareholder of our company. Our controlling interest would cost our rival over $289,000 to purchase, so the vultures we get to pay for a bit. It's time to evaluate our opponents to spot potential weaknesses. At this moment, Ritty 6 is both the cheapest and the most stock available. This is our clear tiger. We already have a good amount of production dedicated to food and electronics. Time to get more glass moving forward. It looks like the price is going to be strong for the foreseeable future. So, we're going to build glass. And that has to be built on silicon, right? So, 10 grand worth of resources. Might be able to do that anyway. Bye. And friendly nozzles. Perhaps we are not progressing as quickly as required. Is our weakness that makes you act with such aggression? Is it not our work here in releasing undue burden from your doorstep? Let our work continue. Recess the array of rivals. Consider another to be target of your ambition. I believe my assessment is just fine. Masters of the universe. Randy 6 seems to have stumbled out of the gate. It really is the kindest to buy him out swiftly. On the subject of speed, it's time to consider building an off-world market. Out of all of the advanced buildings, it's clearly most costly to construct. It is worth every dollar. The platinum rush in the asteroid belt makes certain miners wealthy. It'll help them unload their new foundry. Does it work? You can look at off-world prices by selecting the rocket icon in the lower left corner of the screen. Okay. Boop. Constructing an off-world market. Same tile. And... I mean, the first construct one, you're painting a bullseye on yourself. To unveil your offer marker from sight. This way, holographic technology. What will it look like to the world? There's a lot to this game. There's some depth to it. There's just enough hostility to keep it interesting. It's kind of like a space Sim City kind of thing, but you know, and several levels cooler.
Offworld Market is assembled. Our fortune awaits.
The hologram market will protect you from some unwanted attention. Oh, the hologram will take you. Okay, so all right, so you can see what's more expensive than they are on Mars. Okay, instead of micromanaging the launch, all you need to do is set up a series of repeated shipments. Oh, okay, so we can just do this.
Offworld shipment launched. Look at all the money.
Oh, that looked cool. Left control, left shift click to auto launch. Okay, this is a well-deserved and probably earned pile of cash. Now we need to decide what to do with it. We could take those profits and invest in our growing infrastructure, but it's fairly clear that Rennie Six is in trouble. If we lend a hand, do not confuse help with a bailout. We need to help ourselves with their we will need to help ourselves with their motley price stock. Rennie Six needs a holiday. Lending a hand. Looks like you aim to put Rennie Six out of business. I can't say I disagree. I figured I would help speed the process along and ensure that your conversion
launch affirmative. What a payout
to yourself. Hopefully you appreciate this kind of gesture. Sure. Unexpected data saying, what effects lead to such cruel set of reactions? This was never a predicted outcome. My operating procedures were clear, and my execution was without flaw. The models and forecasted outcomes are well within margin of error. Please do not initiate my early retirement. This is there's much good work. It's not personal, believe me. Obviously, Rennie 6 has bigger problems than mismanaging resources and an underdeveloped communication chip. Time to pull the trigger and buy that sixth block of stocks. Once you do that, Rennie 6 will be removed from the equation and the business will become our subsidiary. We won't be in direct control of their assets, but the subsidiary does provide a steady revenue stream. Oh, and then there's the phone. Oh, that was hilarious. My mom put her phone down and it accidentally called me. So, let's see. What are we doing? So, Rennie 6 made himself an easy target. Can't guarantee the other two won't go down as easily. That's why we have to build our success quickly. Upgrade the expansive HQ to its maximum capacity as we start construction of another off-world market. Improve our... whatever. Build an off-world market. So we're building another one.
Launch affirmative. What a payout.
Is that ours? Let's put next... Oh, I bet you if we stack them together. Build a greenhouse farm. Okay. Do those have to be built anywhere in particular? Oh, let's stack them. 75 bonus. electrolysis reactors, stack them. And a power generator. Is there a geothermal availability? There is. Okay. I'm looking forward to when I get to the point in this game where I'm completely free to do whatever
Successful off-world shipment. Make room for the profits.
Whoosh.
The off-world market is finished and awaiting orders.
Oh, these all have
A robotics HQ has been upgraded.
Oh, things are going well. Okay. So as soon as that power generator completes, we should be on to the next thing. Probably buying out everybody else. These guys are down to a buck. Are you getting a good taste of winning yet? Wait a minute. Do you know what our corporate goal is here? I rushed ahead to implement a business strategy while first breaking down the high-level objective. We could acquire competition. Okay. Need to buy them out? It's time to get hostile with the parolees.
Offworld shipment launched.
Has demonstrated
Look at all the money.
The connections with the black market could really dampen our momentum.
Launch affirmative. What a payout.
I suggest you also use the black market to purchase an adrenaline boost. Safe and legal stimulant that enhances productivity where it's administered. Okay. Okay. We got lots of money.
Successful off-world shipment. Make room for the profits.
Here off-world I was believing that we're all friendly launched. And whatnot, working together
Look
to take out that good for nothing robot. I'm not sure why you get kicked over this particular hornet's nest, but you got my attention.
A robotics HQ has been upgraded.
Perhaps even divesting yourself of your interest in us. That is, if you're interested in survive out there, I'll survive, thanks. Those five blocks of shares Sam was able to buy are just enough to protect her from losing control of her company. Our only option is to take her company out of the equation by staging a very expensive hostile takeover. Instead of buying one block at the top, we'll have to buy those remaining five blocks as a set. The price is twice the price.
Launch affirmative. What a payout.
We're also running low on a few key resources. We can't do it. Small setback. Seems to me that someone should be a little more careful with refueling of those delivery rockets.
Make room for the profits.
Here's a well-known fact you may not be too familiar with. Jet fuel is quite flammable. Perhaps you'd like to move your focus from an aggressive and wanted business takeover to taking care of your own business. Just a suggestion. Believe me, I am focused. Time for some closure. I was hoping to avoid this kind of violent activity. There's really no way to around it. And Reclamation Industries is not known for their subtlety. We got so caught up in outselling everyone that we forgot to protect our second off-world market. Thankfully, the other one is still trying to do the hologram. After this aggressive move, the stakes are clear. I didn't forget. You just...
Offworld shipment launched. Look at all the money.
Build an elemental quarry on silicon. Build a water pump. Bonus. Under construction. Okay. An elemental quarry on silicon. This one? Okay. So, we're probably going to have to take over Crichton Industries too, aren't we? We can't afford to spare ourselves too thin, especially with that aggressive stock purchases that will give our rivals a common enemy. Let's stick to the script and focus on this. Oh, that was why I clicked on that.
Launch affirmative. What a payout!
I knew you had it in you. This is the kind of relentless drive I wish we could instill in all my employees. Remember how often I tell the team to be their own CEO and forget the, and to own their outcomes? They still don't get it. I'm the CEO. Can I give myself a raise? Don't get too carried away over your success. Still work to be done. There's a burning pile of rubble that was our off-world market. We need to get that repaired and back online. Silas Crichton has been left alone, and if we allow him to get his research on, he'll quickly surpass our production capabilities. Keep the financial pressure going. Prepared. Let's make sure we take care of investment this time around. I'm pretty sure Crichton doesn't know about our hologram protected off-road market, so all we need to do is hire goon squads. Yeah, not to delay. We want to make sure there isn't a delay. Okay, we're just gonna hire a goon squad. So one's protected with goon squads, the other one's
successful off-world shipment. Make room for the profits.
3D rockets. Purchase filthy pirates. Okay, so I guess we're supposed to then what? We need to make sure that
Offworld market is assembled. Our fortune awaits.
By a speedy recovery and a full response. Okay, our target will be a union representative. Okay, slow down, Strike. Where's his off-world market?
Off-world shipment launched. Look at all the money. Pirates. I hate those filthy bandits.
This typical behavior reserved for the incarcerated. Are you really so desperate to stifle our progress that you resort to such depths of depravity? I guess your behavior proves that the line between criminal and corporation truly has vanished. You may hinder our progress at this moment, but realize that science and knowledge will ultimately prevail over greed and ignorance.
Sure will. Launch affirmative. What a payout.
Perform a hostile takeover. Will you shift click? Heck of a job! You stayed focused.
Successful off-world shipment.
After you made
make room for the profits,
and rivals end up getting being our subsidiaries. This is the kind of approach you need to continue with if you want to plan on setting up a winning streak. In fact, if you follow my footsteps, you too will become truly unshakable wherever you decide to apply yourself. By the end of your training, you too will be prepared to realize your full potential. Time for a firewalk? There's only one left. Yoshimi Robotics have decided to expand their business into the education sector, creating a franchise for profit colleges. Spearheading their latest efforts is Joe G5. He's among the first to successfully harness the energy of this dangerous moon. If you want to achieve greatness now, I guess we do. Look at the bunnies. Look at the bunnies. Trusted help working forever till the end. Yes, he's back. It's hard to imagine you for being prepared to handle running a business on Io. I suppose that's why you decided to participate in this educational offering. That's such a charming determination not becoming a desperate search for meaning. Perhaps you could be convinced to return to Earth. The world inhospitable is quite apt in describing the new Jupiter. Extreme radiation requires precautions, which decreases efficiencies. Massive temperature differences prevent the challenge for even our robotic workforce. Just tell me what I need to do. Your future is bleak. Solar condenser. Okay, so we need this. Attach it. I don't think that I'll kill two ions like this. Okay, let's do this. Let's stack them. What is that bonus? I should be able to slap this stuff together pretty quickly. I guess you'll get to pick where you want to build, and it's a different set of things. Okay. Water processor. Take to our customers and play with the quality of food grown. I have these same customers have donated their patient to quality of food. Food grown on an irradiated plant with a high density of sulfur must be an acquired taste. Okay. Prepare the num-nums. I'm not even worried about the bonuses, though. We have to slap this through and get through the, get through this thing. This is taking longer than I've intended. But it's a very complicated game. Exceptional, amazing work. I continue to explore flattery as a strategic, I bet you do. Perhaps you can understand my strong recommendation to leave the work to your robotic siblings. Seven claims to achieve a minimal level of life support, and you have yet to establish a path to profitability. What are we building? Okay. Uranium! Warning, they deplete when mined. To release the flavors in uranium, you must build nuclear plants. The closest human experience to have the power from uranium is pie. Wonderful. So I'll take some pie then. Build two nuclear plants. Do we need more money or something? I need approval. We need to upgrade. Oh, just one metal mine. Okay, so we only need one. It's a fact. At one point in the story, similar power plants provide energy for human consumption. Many were constructed close to population centers. Some were constructed near geological fault lines. For projects such fearless parental figures to emulate, we learned to be more conscious. And these energy sources have made IO the only logical location to develop the large-scale foundry operations instead of calling some humans a new world. The darkest days are behind us. Magma smelting! We can... okay. Basalt platforms, okay. I'm gonna stack this in here. 75% bonus somehow. I thought they had to be of like type. Then a lot of metal. There's still no men doing two basalt platforms. Must have 10 steel to construct. There we go. Let me just wait for 10 steel to come back up. I'm really tired of just constantly reading. Come on, let's go. Okay, so that's should be all we have to do is consult those two platforms. I wonder if you just have to pick which plant you want to work on when you set yourself up, whether it's here or there. You have to have stuff going on both. Strictly better. It should be kind of the default to provide a plethora of upgrades in a more traditional mining. I'm told that innovation has two parents, necessity and desperation, both are in high supply. What do you mean exactly? Synthetic meat is a patent that allows farms to produce food at an enhanced rate. The only drawback is that the food has an interesting odor. Nutritional deliverables are satisfactory enough, I'm told. Very pragmatic. Early rocket tests on IO resulted in unwanted atmospheric ignitions. Yoshimi Robotics to help to develop a new type of off-world market that uses uranium instead of fuel. To build the space elevator, you need a large stock of glass, aluminum, electronics. Elevator, that's a nice ring to it. Okay. Build two steel models. Stack them. Dude, that high source of wound could be instead of a source of the unreliable. Okay. Where are we in the world? Radiation storm! Danger, danger, high radiation. These storms pose a threat to biological life and ultra our complex circuitry, which is why our construction requirements are so rigorously updated. Regardless of the quality of our engineering, these storms reduce the shipping capabilities by 50%. Fortunately, our ion collector has received the production keys. At least we're safe, right? That just changes your status. Start the patent lab, okay. Put this out on the edge. Dangerous place! The streets are really rather extreme in their nature. The ground shakes around any building, it's a failed state. Is it on fire? So we gotta wait on that. What do I... How do I... How do we clear that? Do I gotta escape?
The patent lab is constructed. Let's get our science on.
That was really a pair of things. Yeah, it's starting to feel more and more like SimCity. Okay, I think, should we fix everything? So now we need to build that space elevator. Okay, do we have an electronic? Listen, we just buy them? Patent synthetic meat. Okay, so those two are competing with each other. Synthetic meat. You know, you can get that. I mean, that's the thing. You get, vegan meat kind of things. Well, that elevator is building itself to the... Can you see the top? Yeet. It seems to be working.
The space elevator is complete. Let's watch our profits climb.
Okay. And as I recall, we can set these to...
now we'll watch our profits climb.
Here in 5 seconds, we will have created synthetic meat. Quite extraordinary. It looks like your perseverance isn't as broken as our initial interaction led us to believe. With this encouragement in mind, I would kindly request that you refrain from overreacting in the immediate future. Looks like there's yet another IO quake about to hit. Didn't we just finish repairing everything? Sometimes an IO surviving and repairing a terrible company is enough to beat the competition. In fact, our experience here led us to believe that not falling down the stairs is a new eyeball. Would you be willing to participate in a brief survey about your learning session? Certainly. Work on IOs dirty and hard. Sometimes it can be frustrating.
Space elevator delivery.
I'm ready.
So much money.
Curriculum for success. Running an offworld business is a very large endeavor, filled with problems and obstacles. I wonder if I would have gotten more content like this if I'd signed the non-disclosure. Yes, I felt cared for. Warm regards. Even though I have doubted your abilities from the beginning, even you could not be blinded by to my excellence. Perhaps if you apply yourself in your endeavors, you will experience a modicum of success. A success that will put together. Regrets. I have them. Congratulations, graduate. We're so proud of you. As it burns down. All right! We now know how to play, folks, and I think that's enough for today. Ooh, multiplayer game available. So much. We'll do some single player in the future, but right now, my eyes are tired. This has been a long one. On this note, lots of things to look forward to in the future, folks, as we build our empire. In the meantime, this is your Black Knight. Have a great night.